Ladies and gentlemen, we are 6 nights away from the Elimination Chamber. Welcome to NSW Raw. My name is, of course, Dave East, and I am alongside Maz Freeway. Maz, tonight, two big matches to determine the last two entrants in the Elimination Chamber, and of course, a huge tag team main event.
Yep, Mr. Perfect has definitely stacked the card heading into Elimination Chamber, and I can't wait to see this big main event happen.
Coming up, we are going to start off things off with the Internet Championship. You voted in Matt Rhodes. He will take on the champion, Kevin King. It is your opening contest of Raw this week.
Yep, this should be an interesting matchup to see if the King can retain his title.
Indeed it is. You voted in Matt Rhodes. And here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, the groovy one, Matt Rhodes.
Yep, everyone dancing his way down the ring, looking to pick up his first internet championship.
Yeah, a chance for Matt Rhodes to add to the collection, of course, of what he of championships he's had here. And of course, Maz, can he topple the King here tonight?
Yeah, if he picks up this internet championship, he would be the first ever, one of the four-time title holders here on Raw, I think.
Yeah. The accolades of Matt Rhodes, of course, the groovy one, world champion, NXT champion, European champion, NSW tag team champion, hardcore champion, but never internet champion, and a chance for that to add to his collection here tonight, Maz. And really, the fans voted Matt Rhodes in so much over everyone else. This is going to be an interesting matchup to start tonight.
Hope to see if everyone can do it here.
He's up against, though, ladies and gentlemen, a two-time internet champion. Ladies and gentlemen, he is Kevin King.
All hail the King. The King is finally here to defend his internet championship.
A championship he won last week right here on Raw. Can Kevin King, well, go into Elimination Chamber still your internet champion? Remember, ladies and gentlemen, next week there will be no internet championship match, as of course we have the draft next week right here on Raw. ECW, Raw and SmackDown will all be represented in matches in longer and shorter than usual. 10 matches, 3 on the pre-show, 7 on the main card, 10 picks altogether. Who is going to get them? You will have to find out next week. But for now, your internet champion is here.
So what you're saying, Dave, is going to be the first ever NSW Super Show?
Well, you'd have to say it's going to be more than a Super Show. Of course, draft is usually just a normal matches. But, well, all three brands have agreed to go for 10 picks this time. You do not want to miss it, ladies and gentlemen. Starting from 10:30. In the UK on for Superstars, and then Raw, of course, coming your way 11 o'clock in the UK next week right here on the NSW underscore network. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to vote, you can do so. Tell us who you think is going to win this opening contest. Kevin King, that internet championship, Maz, just looks like it's just fitted around him perfectly.
Yeah, he's definitely taking a claim to be an internet champion and really loves the accolades he gets from being there from all the internet fans here in the arena.
Well, Kevin King, who won that championship from Ryan Fox last week, hands it over to Rooney Wayne. Matt Woods would love to add that to his collection. What an opening contest, ladies and gentlemen. This is all thanks to you. Remember, you vote the challenger for the Internet Championship each and every week. You guys get to decide this. This is what Mr. Perfect, he puts it in your hands. You pick the challenger, and here we go for the opening contest. Maz Freeway, who is walking away with the gold here tonight?
The King has definitely looked strong defending this Internet Championship, and might have to go with the King here tonight. I think he's going to look to try and hold on to that championship.
Well, just have a look. 83.3 for Matt Rhodes, 16.7 for Kevin King. We thank you for your vote, of course, as we tie up in the corner here. Rooney Wynn trying to get involved. What's going to happen? Clean break. Yeah, well, look at that. A clean break from both men. I don't know if that's a sign of mutual respect there from both men, Maz, as the lock up in the corner. Back and forth they go, and there's the wrestling takedown. That's the technique of Kevin King. He will make sure he looks to take you down at every opportunity, assert his dominance into the matchup, and this is one thing that Matt Rhodes has got to be careful of.
Yeah, the King will get in there, and he'll definitely want to brawl with him, and he's definitely got the moves to do it if he wants to.
Look at this now. And Matt Rhodes with a lovely knee right to the face of Kevin King. Shots again, back and forth. Sending King stunned in the corner. Rhodes sends King off the ropes. And oh, went for the big knee. Nice. Duck out the way by King. And now King will look to take advantage with a lovely back suplex.
And King just staying one step ahead of the groove on here in this opening moments of this match.
Big shots right to the top of the head. Kevin King, your internet champion, two-time internet champion, the only person to have held it twice here in NSW. Looking to assert more dominance over Matt Rhodes as he goes into the headlock. Armbar then into that takedown, and then look at this. This is what Kevin King is all about. Looking to punish you in so many ways, Maz, as Matt Rhodes is finding out here.
And he's looking to pinpoint a body part and really looking to work it over. And just as I say that, looks like the Groovy One's turning this one around a little bit, looking to maybe soften up Kevin King, but King's just staying one step ahead.
Nice shot by Matt Rhodes, taking it down. And then what's he going to do here? Just nice shot again, side the head, just showing Kevin King exactly what you can do. I can do better. Apologies, we are expecting Marky Marks here, sadly due to a lot of traffic around New York. We is due to come here at any time. I do believe we are being told that
Hello.
We are joined. Yeah, we are being joined. Get your headset on there, Marky. You're a little bit... How's the traffic?
Well, let me tell you, it took me in half an hour just to move 1 inch.
My goodness, that is what it is like, ladies and gentlemen, in New York, of course. But we're glad you're here. You're here in the opening contest, Internet Championship. Mm-hmm. Look at Matt Rhodes.
Nope. I didn't miss much.
Nope. Fair opening contest. Matt Rhodes being voted in by the NSW Universe. And Kevin King in control. Oh, super kick! Nice shot into the cover. And a kick at it, too. So close.
I thought the Groovy One was going to be on Dream Street there.
They look very close. And now, watch out. Gut Buster.
Now, oh wait, now we're going to put him away.
Yeah, Kevin King looking to end Matt Rhodes' dream of becoming the Internet Championship. Look out!
Oh,
it's the sit-out powerbomb! Is that enough? Yes, it is! And Kevin King retains the Internet Championship here tonight.
Another amazing defense by Kevin King for his Internet Championship.
Yep. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest and still Internet Champion, Kevin King. What will be in store for the King and the Internet Championship? Will he even still be on Raw come the draft in next week? Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, who will be the fifth member in the chamber match for the World Heavyweight Championship? It's either going to be Rob Dundee or Carlos. It comes up next on Raw. New York, New York, as Marky finds out, is a very busy place, but it's going to be lit up, ladies and gentlemen, by this man. He is from Scotland, Rob Dundee.
And one half of the high-flying Scots, and now looking to make his way into this match and hopefully beat Carlos here and get into the Elimination Chamber.
Well, Marky, what a big chance for Rob Dundee to get into the chamber here tonight.
Yeah, let's see if Dundee can really prove himself here, and will we get a big win here for the Scots, and like you said, get into that big chamber.
Dundee looking forward to seeing if he can become really, if he can change most of the luck. He hasn't had much of the luck, as you can see here in Raw, but tonight could be that big change.
This could be his breakout match, but if one man's going to have something to say about it, it will be the resident redneck.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent making his way to the ring, he is Carlos.
One man who's looking to get into a major title hunt, and what a great chance this would be for him to get into the Elimination Chamber and be one of the six to have a chance to take that title home.
Yeah, Marky, I'm sure you agree that the Chamber is really it. If you get a good draw in the Chamber, it is all in your favor come Sunday night.
Yeah, really. It is anyone's game into the Chamber. If you get, like, the last one into the Chamber, you have a well big chance to pick up that championship.
And of course, the championship being held by Zadlan. We're going to see Zadlan and his arch enemy Luke Benoit having to tag team here tonight as they take on Adrian Kincaid and Jess Jarrett in our main event. And Maz has been looking forward to.
Yeah, I can't wait to see the major explosion of this matchup. How will Zadlan and Luke Benoit get along? And can Kincaid and Jess get along? I mean, I know they both are looking to get into the Elimination Chamber and become champions, so we'll have to see if they can all get along, and we'll have a great match here tonight.
Well, talking about the Chamber, who's going to qualify for the Chamber? It is going to be a chance here for either of these two men. Big opportunity. Let's see what Marky has to say about this one.
Well, I'm going to go for the Scotsman here. I'm going to go for Dundee. I think he's going to be able to pick up a big win and win his way into the Chamber.
What about you, Maz? Who are you going for this one?
I think I'm going to have to go with Carlos. I think this is going to be his chance to show that he's ready to move it up and he's ready to brawl with the best of them, and I think he can do it here tonight against Rob Dundee.
Well, NSW app, thank you again for voting so much. Much appreciated. 83.3 for Rob Dundee and 16.7 for Carlos. Thank you very much for taking the time to vote in the NSW app, as Carlos taking Dundee to the outside here. And this is where you would say Carlos is dangerous here, Maz, but Rob Dundee equally, I would say, dangerous on the outside.
Yeah, but I think if you had to pick out of the two of them, who would be better using toys and the weapons underneath their ring here, I think I'd have to go with Carlos.
Well, inside the ring here, Carlos, nice knee lift. Again, just shots and goes. If you're going to brawl, you would think that, again, you would think Carlos may have the advantage here, Marky, in the brawling techniques. But Rob Dundee, we've seen, can be the best of the brawler and best of them.
Yeah, we've seen Dundee really be a big hard hitter, and well, right now he's not really proving it here against Carlos so far. Carlos all over
him. Nice drop of the elbow. What's he going to think about doing? Nope. Nice reversal. Nice fisherman by Rob Dundee. Can get you in so many ways. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you keep your thoughts. Tell us your thoughts, of course, in the NSW app. Tell us what you think, of course, with the Chamber being 6 nights away. We'll see what these guys think. We'll get a prediction of these guys towards the end of the show. As Raw continues, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Well, guys, do not forget about all of our shows. Of course, Monday Night, which right now for Raw, Wednesday for ECW, Thursday for SmackDown, Saturday for NXT. Our times are 11 UK, 7 East, 4 in the West for this week. NSW_360 is our Twitter. Nonstop Wrestling UK to catch all of our shows that have ever happened. NSW365 for our Facebook. The rankings will be coming back soon. And NSW_network to catch it live on Twitch.tv.
Indeed it is. And of course, you will be there for the Chamber on Sunday night. Nice sit-out powerbomb as we come back to the action. Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching NSW Raw. Who is going to qualify for the Chamber match during the break? Carlos taking advantage of Rob Dundee here being in control. There's that arm right under the chin. Maz, and this is just to wear down the big man. Rob Dundee in a lot of trouble here.
This is just trying to slow him down, trying to use Carlos's weight to kind of sit on the back of Rob Dundee here and kind of take the wind out of him. And we'll just see if Rob Dundee can shake this off and get back into this matchup.
He goes right under the chin again. Now, Rob Dundee, the bigger of the two men, using that height to his advantage. And again, though, Carlos just takes him down. And, well, you're going to see this is not really Carlos's style, but you're going to see, give him credit here for trying something different. But Dundee comes back. Nope, went for the suplex. Oh. And again, Carlos had something better for him. And Marky, sorry, he had him scouted.
Yeah, had him excellently scouted. Really, Carlos definitely watched a lot of tapes before going into this matchup here. Really getting scouted.
Look out. Swinging neck breaker by Carlos, center of the ring. Taking it out of both men, as you can see here. Big opportunity for one of these men to go into the chamber. Carlos, first man to the feet. Now, into the cover. Hook of the leg. Has he got him? No! 2.9!
So just barely. Close.
Look at that. Oh, the flatliner!
Oh, no, this has to be it.
Dundee looking to end this. Looking to go into the chamber. Has he got enough to beat Carlos here? He has!
Wow.
And Rob Dundee is going to the Elimination Chamber.
Will this be a true underdog story for Rob Dundee? Can he get into the... Will he walk out of the Elimination Chamber as the champion?
It could happen. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, Rob Dundee. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to keep things going here. Mango is up next. One half of the tag team champions going to take on one half of the tag team number one contenders, Brody Lee. Coming up next, right here on Raw. New York has been a buzz all day. Marky's already found out as we'll talk a little bit in a minute, but ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first, being accompanied by the Slammy Award-winning manager, Oliver Bisping, he is Umego!
And this should be an interesting match to see how Umego does in singles competition. He's been in quite a few tag team matches lately. Hopefully he hasn't forgotten what it's like to be in the singles.
And Marky, I know you're huge on this guy. Could this be a breakout? Maybe for Umego if he can knock off Brody Lee here tonight.
Yeah, of course, Brody Lee, a very tough competitor here. If Umego finds a way to topple Brody Lee here, this could definitely very much elevate Umego even in the singles competition here.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, big breaking news, of course. The rankings will be back after Elimination Chamber. They will be on our Facebook page, updated after every show. We apologize, they have been away slightly. Blame 2K for that. But we will be bringing them back after the chamber. But ladies and gentlemen, business is about to pick up because making his way to the ring, being accompanied by fellow Bulletproof Club member, Sean Beatherick, he is Big Bad Brody Lee.
And the Bulletproof Club has looked really good in the past couple of weeks, and I think they're looking to take those tag team champions off of one sec at the Elimination Chamber.
Could this be, Marky, the biggest challenge to one sec's tag team titles this Sunday night?
Yeah, I think this is definitely a very big challenge for one sec. I don't think they face anyone like these guys here, so it's going to be very interesting to see how they're going to do and see if they're going to get all the momentum here by beating Brody Lee here.
Definitely these two men, since becoming a part of the Bulletproof Club, have definitely risen up the tag team ranks. Who is one sec the final stop to becoming one of the best tag team on Raw? That is the question. Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Rooney Wayne says we're often underway two big heavy hitters. As of course Marky likes to say, I hope they've reinforced the ring. Because this could be. There is a lot of mass in that ring at the moment. And look at that lovely leg drop by Omega. Let's see what Maz has to say though about this one. Maz, who are you going for the win on this one?
I'm going to have to go with, I think, Brody Lee and Sean Beatherick. I think they're just Brody Lee himself is just impressive, and I don't know if Muggle's going to be able to take down the big man.
What about you? Marky, who are you going for in this one?
I'm going to go for Muggle here. I think he'll be able to pick up what some would say would be an upset victory here, especially with Omega mainly being a tag team competitor.
Okay, of course, ladies and gentlemen, it all happens this Sunday night at the Elimination Chamber. One Sec versus the Bulletproof Club. You do not want to miss it, of course. What a match that is going to be. One Sec very much not going to be in like every other tag match. I think they're not going to be overwhelming favourites, especially with Brody Lee. Of course, and you know, and Mr. Certain Adrian Kincaid being on the outside for that one.
Absolutely.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you keep going on to our social media. Tell everybody where we are, as we see each and every week as a big DDT. But how much Maz will that do for someone like a Megal? You drop a Megal on his head, it's not really going to do any damage.
I just think it's trying to wear him down a little bit, and it seems like it really didn't have an effect because. Omega's got control of this matchup now and looking to really work over the arm of Brody Lee here.
Look at this again, Megal. Not many people will tower over this big Samoan. But look at this. Brody Lee just manhandling another boot right to the side of the jaw. Marky.
Could have knocked him out.
Yeah, and I gotta say it, that'll stun anyone, and I don't care who you are.
Yeah, that would just absolutely stun and maybe even, like I said, knock out anyone, but Omega right back up here, but right back down.
Back and forth again.
Looks like Brady's just raking at the face of Omega.
Would you say it's more like desperate tactics, Maz?
I think he's just trying to take the wind out of the big man here, kind of slow him down and get him winded, so it's a better opportunity for Brody Lee to set up for that big jackknife powerbomb.
Snap me a takeover, Brody Lee off the ropes. Big boot right into the side of the face, and then the knee to the back of the head.
Oh my goodness.
Is Brody Lee going to try and make sure that Omega doesn't even make Sunday night? What's he going to do down here? Just stamp down the side of the arm. Sean Bethrick, Sean the Show, on the outside, of course. And look at this. Nope, nice reversal. Is anyone, even a tag team Samoan, can do a Russian leg sweep? And now, oh no.
Oh
look
no.
Look at the strength of Omega, who
what?
Just picks him up and drills Brody Lee into the mat. This could be it. Into
this
the
has
cover.
To be.
Two? No! And how many people have we seen kick out of that, Marky?
Not many, but really, how many people can pick up Big Bad Brody Lee like that?
Maz, you look a little bit stunned there next to you. What do you make of this contest so far?
Muggle's just on fire right now, and Bisping's definitely got his man here all riled up and ready to go for this match, and he is showing no fear against Big Brody Lee.
Look at this now. Megal, what are you going to do here? A German suplex! Ooh. My goodness, he picked Brody Lee look like he was a toy! This is unbelievable.
Absolutely nothing.
And now, look at this, into the cover. Is that enough to put away Brody Lee? No, just a two.
Ooh.
And now, look at this, just down across the arm. Omega has been in control. Do you find that a bit surprising, Marky, in this one?
Yeah, very shocking here, because especially knowing what Big Bad Brody Lee has done in singles competition, but now in here, more what's getting dominated here by Omega.
What's he going to do here? Turn around. Omega. Is he going to try and finish off Brody Lee? Maz right here. Looking to go up to that second rope.
Oh.
Drop all that weight down onto his chest.
Oh, my goodness me. I think that could be enough to put away Brody Lee. Hook of the leg. Well, Megal's foot looks a bit under the rope. Oh, whoa. Sean Bethrick pulled the referee out of the ring.
Disqualify that man.
Well, the referee.
Can't touch the ref.
Sean Bethrick and the referee really weren't discussing it on the outside, but that was definitely, I think, a Michael had this match won. And the big punch by Brodie Lee, and all of a sudden now this could be a win for Brodie Lee, and no, a kick at it too.
Just goes to show that the BPC will do what it takes to win a match.
But the thing is, how much does Brodie Lee have? And oh, look at this, and Michael picks him up again. Is this enough? Drills him into the mat, second time.
And I don't think
Sean Bethwick can do anything this time. I think that is it.
Don't you dare touch him.
Three, got him. And Megal picks up the win here tonight. Momentum for one sec going into Sunday night. Ladies and gentlemen.
I want to win for one sec.
Yep, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, Megal.
What an amazing one.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, six-man tag team action. Disney Express and Travis Soule take on Team Canada and our United States champion, Bobby Hall. This is going to be some great action coming up next on Raw. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first the tag team of AJ Z and Killer Whale, the Disney Express.
Yep, the Disney Alliance is looking strong here tonight. Hopefully we'll see the bunny back here soon. He's been MIA for a little while now, but he's definitely got his crew here, and they're looking to pick up a big win here against Team Canada and Bobby Hall.
Well, from what I've heard, Maz, and I think Marky, I know how much Marky loves, of course, Mr. Hardcore Legend himself, Joe Disney.
That's what he, buddy.
I've been heard from the rumors, of course. I don't get to speak to him. From the rumors, I've been hearing that he's looking for new clients.
Whoa, new clients.
Well, apparently that is the rumors, saying that he is looking for potential new clients, and he will be back in a couple of weeks.
Hopefully he'll be here for Easter.
Oh, you think so? Ladies and gentlemen, their tag team partner, he is the number one contender for the United States Championship. He is Travis Soule.
The main hairstyle is for Joe Disney. And we'll have to see if Travis Soule can get a win here with the Disney Alliance to give him the momentum to go in to beat Bobby Hall at the pay-per-view.
Well, why doesn't Travis Soule come up with the rest of the Disney Alliance?
Because he's his own man.
Just because he's a hairstylist?
Hey, that man is paid a lot of money. You do not mock Marky, this official stylist to Team Disney.
I bet he cuts your hair.
Look, I'm not revealing who cuts my hair. Enough said.
Fair enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Soule ready for action here tonight. Are you a big fan, Maz, of Travis Soule?
Yeah, I think Travis Soule is great. I think he's going to become the next United States champion at Elimination Chamber.
Could well happen, of course. But he's not facing anybody. He's facing Bobby Hall, and tonight he's going to be teaming up with, well, people he knows very well, ladies and gentlemen. Introducing their opponents, the team of TJ Carter and Canadian Tom, Team Canada!
And we'll see if Team Canada can help Bobby Hall pick up the win here tonight and maybe get themselves back into the hunt for those tag team championships.
Yeah, Team Canada, of course, under the Travis Keller family, of course. Know Bobby Hall very well. Bobby Hall managed by Travis Keller in Season 3. And these two guys really grown in popularity. Marky, do you find that strange with the NSW crowd, or do you think it's deserved?
Well, after all of these guys done here in NSW, I think it is deserved. These guys are great guys, and Team Canada, we're getting right behind with the fans here.
Well, Ladies and gentlemen, the tag team partner, he is the United States champion, Bobby Hall.
Here comes Bobby Hall, looking to show that he is still our United States champion and wants to prove it come Elimination Chamber by taking down Travis Soul and looking for the next competitor.
Yep. This man has, well, ruled the United States division for a long time. And, well, is Travis Soul going to be the man to end that for Sunday night? You have to say, ladies and gentlemen, Travis Soul will have to do something big to defeat this man. Marky, do you see Bobby Hall's United States Championship under any threat come Sunday night?
Well, it is definitely under threat here. Of course, he's going against Travis Soul, of course, a part of the Disney Alliance. And, well, Travis, a great competitor in the ring, of course, has the current record for the most amount of Russian leg suits in one match.
That is very true. As AJZ and TG Cart are going to kick things off today in this one. See what Marky has to say under this one.
I'm going to go for the Disney Alliance here. I think they're going to be able to pick up a big win over Team Canada and Bobby Hall here.
Okay, what about you, Maz? Who are you going for in this one?
Yeah, I'm about to do the same with Marky. I'm going to have to ride with the Disney Alliance. I just think they're a much stronger, cohesive team than Team Canada is together, along with Bobby Hall.
Well, 100% of the NSW app going for Joe Disney and Travis Soul. Looks like they're very much on the side of the challenger here come Sunday night. AJZ thrown into the ropes by TJ Carter. And a nice swinging neck breaker. TJ Carter definitely a standout in the Travis Keller family, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Now just looking to continue the beatdown on AJZ. And, oh, what a shot just to the side of the arm. And TJ Carter on a little bit of a roll here. And now look at this, just trying to take the legs down of AJZ. Marky, good tactic.
Yeah, really, well, really, you take out the bodybuilder legs there, and he won't be able to lift you up or anything. So I would definitely say very good tactic here. But, oh, but the whoa there.
Well, of course, anything like that will stop you dead in your tracks. And, oh, no, here comes the big man, Killer Whale. Maz's face just lit up. I know you're a big fan of this guy.
It's like David versus Goliath in there, and looks like David actually got the upper hand right now, but I'm sure give it some time and Big Killer Whale is going to take control of this matchup.
Look at this, TJ Carter trying to do anything to take the big man off his feet. No, that'll do just nicely. TJ Carter, nope, sweep of the legs. As Raw continues, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with the conclusion of this six-man tag match. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, the Elimination Chamber comes your way the 27th of March, this Sunday night. Who will leave as the NSW champion, and who will leave as the World Heavyweight Champion? You will have to find out come Sunday night at the Elimination Chamber. There's no turning back. We are back, ladies and gentlemen, just in time. Look at the strength!
Whoa,
Canadian Tom! Oh, but it was too much for him. You can't do that to someone the size of Killer Whale, Maz.
It's gonna take somebody a little bit stronger than Canadian Tom, but Killer Whale locking on this sleeper hold there and really wearing him down.
And now here comes Travis Soul in. Picked the pieces more like, as Canadian Tom looking to try and get back to his rope, but Travis Soul going to the top. No, I thought he was going to try something there, but realised better of it. Sends Canadian Tom into the corner here. And no, the boot in the corner had him waiting here. Canadian Tom looking back suplex. This is a chance for Canadian Tom here to get a tag. Bobby Hall telling him to get to the corner, and here we go. But Canadian Tom not. Is
Come
he going
on,
to tag
get him
out?
In.
Yes, he is. Here we go. This is what we're going to see Sunday night, ladies and gentlemen. Bobby Hall and Travis Sewell, and here we go. And Travis Sewell getting the better of the champ.
But the champ right back on him.
Yeah, look out. Oh, lovely neck breaker by Bobby Hall. And now just the punches to the side of the head.
It seems Bobby Hall can't wait to get his hands on Travis Sewell and truly laying into him right now.
And oh, what a suplex! Bobby Hall, you can see AJZ feeling the effects of this match. And Bobby Hall, now look at this. No, went for a sleeper, but then realized that more people, he was in the wrong corner and let it go. Wise by the champion there, Marky.
Yeah, really just great ring awareness there by our champion. That's really is why he's champion, but look at this.
Deadlift. Oh, goodness, that is the strength of Bobby Hall into the cover. Has he got one over the challenger come Sunday night? Yes, he has! Bobby Hall has put away Travis Sewell, and that's huge, Maz, for Sunday night.
Yeah, Bobby Hall's just showing you how strong he is and how powerful he is. He's able to knock out Travis Sewell there and get the win for him and Team Canada, and what a win for Bobby Hall.
Yeah, Bobby Hall, all the momentum for that United States defense come Sunday night. Big win here on Raw this week. Coming up next, it's the last chance to get in the chamber. Will it be Ryan Diaz or Ryan Fox? We'll know the six men after this match. Who will it be? We'll find it next on Raw. Ladies and gentlemen, in addition first, he is a member of the Realist Guys. He is Juan Diaz.
We'll have to see if Juan can pick up a potential big win here for him and show that the Realist Guys can actually get a win.
Well, former internet champion Marky, are you big on this guy?
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the Realist Guys here. I think Juan Diaz can pick up a big win for the Realist Guys and get himself into the chamber and getting the Realist Guys a championship here yet again.
Well, Juan making his way in, and he loves to spell it out for you each and every week. And I'm sure you'd like to stick it to Maz Freeway again here tonight. Could we be looking at the new World Heavyweight Champion?
Could very well be.
But, ladies and gentlemen,
my worst nightmare.
That is true. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent making his way to the ring. He is from Detroit, Michigan, Ryan Fox.
The excellence of execution, the greatest Disney member alive, and crown jewel of the Disney Alliance. Can't wait to see if him pick up the big win here tonight and move on to Elimination Chamber and win that title back.
You see the crown jewel. Many people see that AJZ is fighting for that, but this man is 3-time World Heavyweight Champion, 1-time Internet Champion, and has won Raw Money in the Bank before. Marky, you can't disagree what man say. This man really is a crown jewel.
Yeah, he really is. That Dastardly Bunny is the big jewel here. Him and AJZ, like you said, fighting for that big spot. Well, really, a big win here. Maybe take the jewel.
Well, there's a spot in the Elimination Chamber waiting for one of these men. Who will be the sixth man? We will find out next on Raw.
Anybody wants to know what the Fox is saying? He says he's going to Elimination Chamber.
Well, let's find out. Ryan Fox, Juan Diaz, Rini Wayne ready to go. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're off and underway. Let's see what Maz has to say about this one.
I'm going to have to go with Ryan Fox. He's just so much better of a veteran here in NSW, and I'm sure he's going to take Juan here to the ropes.
Well, let's see what Marky has to say.
I'm going to go for Juan Diaz here. I think his brute power and strength will be able to pick up a big win over Ryan Fox here and really prove himself and that the Realist Guys are something to mess with.
Well, so if that is the case, one Fox really the bit. One Fox? One Diaz, the better, bigger of the two. Look at this, though, from Ryan Fox. Lovely hip toss. Gotta give him credit. A big move, maneuver early on here. Sending Juan into the ropes. And a big power slam takes him over. Of course, the chamber on Sunday night. Five men already in it. Who will become the sixth? Who will be... Really, if you think, Marky, if Juan Diaz does get in that chamber, could you imagine him versus Sadland squaring up against each other?
Yeah, two really big guys going against each other here. I think that would be a great way to start it off.
Look at this here. Nice neck breaker by Juan Diaz. Might as well get your opinion. I know you're not a big fan of Juan Diaz, but could you imagine if him and Sadland just square up in that chamber, what damage that could do?
Yeah, I'm sure the damage that Zadlan could cause onto Juan Diaz would be a tremendous pain to him, and I don't know if Juan would want to step up to someone the size of Zadlan here in NSW.
Well, I would say it's one match that I would definitely like to see, maybe in the future, as Ryan Fox sends Juan onto the ropes, and then over the top, and the big man is eliminated. That's a shame.
It really is.
As Ryan Fox now continues the beatdown on the outside. Of course, a 10 count to play with. Now, the thing is, what if both men get eliminated? What would happen if both men get counted out? That would be very interesting to see what Mr. Perfect would have to do then.
Yeah, what could he do?
Well, what do you do?
I'm sure he'd find a willing participant to step up.
Oh, look at this nice shot by Juan Diaz on the outside. Referee up to a count of six. Oh, the lovely little... Do you see that shuffle right in front of Maz? I love it by Juan Diaz.
Oh, what a shuffle.
And then breaking the count up. Going back to do more damage to Ryan Fox on the outside. Picks him up, backbreaker. And wow. Another shot, this time into the ring post.
Seems Juan's in control here on the outside.
Yeah, now what's Juan looking to do? Oh, getting back inside the ring.
Yep, back inside. Now, of course, you've got to win inside. You count, it will count, of course. Mm-hmm. As Ryan Fox looking to snap the net back. And now Ryan Fox looking to fly here. Oh, that looked a little bit low. Rooney Wayne allowing it to go here.
How?
Well, and now the stretchy man!
Stretchy man!
Taking Juan Diaz, really just... This is why Ryan Fox has been three-time World Heavyweight Champion, Maz.
I'm just showing you why he's got the skills that can pay the bills, and he's looking to show off here and pick up the win, but... You better not get too cocky.
What do you do here? Gets a hold of Juan Diaz. Throws him right into the ring post. The ring shook. And this, Marky, is why, as you're saying, Ryan Fox is just one of the greatest competitors we've had here on Raw.
Yeah, well, White Man says the excellence of execution, one of the best we have here, but a big DDT by Juan Diaz.
Yeah, Juan this Diaz. Be it. Yeah. Completely all of a sudden changing. It looked like he was in a lot of trouble. Rooney Wayne going down. There's the cover. Oh, so close.
What?
That is how close it was from Juan Diaz being in the chamber here after taking all that punishment. Just how quick it can change. But again, Ryan Fox back in control here. What is the Fox doing? Working the leg of the big man. Trying to take the mobility down.
He wasn't able to do it.
And now just taking Juan Diaz over again. Headlock. Arm under the chin. Juan Diaz bigger, the two men. Trying to fight out here. And then the dropkick. Wow! From the big man himself. Now what's he
doing? I didn't even think he could do that.
Oh, not the Saudi Arabian announce table.
They're stuck in traffic too.
Oh, dear me. This is not fair at all. And now, Juan Diaz, what's he going to do? Is he going to look to try and do something to Ryan Fox here? Destroying the announce table? No, he's coming here. Nope, I thought he was going to come near us.
Oh, stay away from us.
Referee Rooney Wint advised him not to do anything, and that gave Ryan Fox just the opportunity to take advantage here.
Ryan Fox just being the smarter of the two. See it, waiting for that moment, and now looking to go a swinging.
My goodness, he is no small man, and Ryan Fox is swinging him around like a toy.
I'm going to puke.
Oh, it's not good. Oh, no. Don't look at it, Marky. Ooh. Dropping him right down. Is that enough? Drawing him around away from the ropes. That could give Juan Diaz the advantage. So no hook of the leg. Very arrogant by Ryan Fox. And only a two. Oh, look out. Oh, Northern Lights by Juan Diaz.
My goodness.
This is how crazy this match has been.
Yeah, but now what's it looking to do?
Don't know. Again, you give Juan Diaz just that little bit of opportunity, and this is what happens. Again, Juan not taking advantage of this. Oh, look at him taunting, and that could cost him.
What?
Big neckbreaker.
Why are they taunts?
Maz, you've got to see, this is give Ryan Fox the perfect opportunity.
Yep, Fox is really turning it up now, hitting it with the 10 elbow drop and looking to maybe send this one home and get the win for the Disney Alliance.
Oh, look out. Big elbow drop, and that is right into the heart of Juan Diaz, and that could do it. Is Fox going to the chamber?
Has to be. What?
A 2.9! And it was that close!
How did he not win?
How did he not pick up the win in that one? And a big spine buster by Juan Diaz! This match has been back and forth! And now, Juan Diaz looking to see if he can go to the chamber! No! Just a two! What a match, ladies and gentlemen, between these two!
A great match!
And now,
man, leaving it all in the ring here tonight.
Look out, Fox! Into the package! Suplex! Has he got him this time? Yes! Ryan Fox is going to the Elimination Chamber! Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, Ryan Fox!
Well, there can only be one man to represent the Disney Alliance in the Elimination Chamber. It'd only be this one man right here, Ryan Fox. What a win for Ryan Fox here tonight. Can't wait to see what he does at Elimination Chamber.
Yep, and talking about Elimination Chamber, these four men will be in it. Kincaid, Jess Jarrett, Luke Benoit, and of course the World Heavyweight Champion, Zadlan. Tag team action for your main event. It's coming up next here on Raw. What a night we've had already, ladies and gentlemen, and this is your main event. Introducing first, he is the greatest country and western singer in NSW history, Jess Jarrett.
Yeah, can't wait to see what Jess has up the sleeve here tonight and for Elimination Chamber.
Yeah, indeed. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the six men are known for the Elimination Chamber. It will be come Sunday night. Zadlan, the World Heavyweight Champion, Adrian Kincaid, Jess Jarrett, Rob Dundee, Ryan Fox, and Luke Benoit. All, well, one of them men, Marky, are going to leave the World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, and which man will it be?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner, he is the leader of the Bulletproof Club, the Natural, Adrian Kincaid.
It's great to see Kincaid up here on the main roster after leaving ECW or being drafted over from ECW and now looking to make his name here on Raw and become heavyweight champion.
Adrian Kincaid, he was tried on so many occasions, Marky, to be world heavyweight champion. Is he one of your favorites to win on Sunday night?
He's definitely up there, but I think it's definitely going to have to be Zadwin. He's going to be retaining it.
Wow, big prediction from Marky Marks, of course. And of course, this night has made it so much clearer from the Raw side. Of course, remember, SmackDown on Thursday night will include that card for Elimination Chamber. What a tag team these two are going to make, but what about this? Talk about dysfunctional, ladies and gentlemen. Introduce him first. He is Luke Benoit.
Oh, no.
Marky, how is Luke Benoit and Zadlan going to even be on the same team? These two guys hate each other.
I don't think this is not going to end well. One man's just going to hit each other here, and it's just going to be an all-out brawl of all these four men.
I think they could go out there and maybe want to show up each other in this matchup, and maybe taking on this team of Kincaid and Jess Jarrett will really help them kind of find a way to work through that.
Well, you have to think, ladies and gentlemen, of course, the history, we all know the history of Luke Benoit and Zadlan, but of course, all four men, of course, Jess Jarrett really is just coming new into the picture. He might have the advantage here, you guys. You've got to think he doesn't have any of the history between these men.
Yeah, well, to see how he gets involved in this matchup, if he will.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, he is your World Heavyweight Champion, Zadlan!
It's always such an eerie sight when the Phenom arrives.
Yeah, Zadlan making his way into the ring. That World Heavyweight Champion, is it going to be in his possession for only six more nights? Or is the Phenom of NSW going to walk into the draft next Monday night? Of course, remember, the main event of the draft next week will be the ECW Champion, the World Heavyweight Champion, and the NSW Champion going in a triple threat match. Will Zadlan be that champion? Will he be Raw's representative come this time next week? Maz, I'm sure you're going to have big things to say about that.
It's going to be a hell of a match.
Zadlan. Marky, your thoughts on Zadlan?
Zadlan really just one of the most dominant champions we've ever had, and really, six-man Women's Chamber is going to be a bit, very big disadvantage for him.
Zadlan. As the lights come on, ladies and gentlemen, ready to start our main event tonight here on NSW World. We thank you for being with us. As I say, six nights from the Chamber. Many people see you on a complete disadvantage at the champion in the Chamber, but really, if there's anyone that can disprove that, Marky, it would be Zadlan.
Yeah, it would have to be. I mean, Zadlan definitely a very dominant person. And well, like I said, it is a disadvantage for him, though, having five other people in there. And what if he gets the first draw and he's one of the first two people in there?
Well, next week, the draft, of course, one of many people's favorite nights, of course, in NSW. Where will everybody be going? And of course, next week's draft, the biggest draft in the history of NSW, but before that, there's so much more to be decided. As Kincaid, I would have to say here, Marky, and I'm going to go out on a limb here, I would say, okay, Kincaid and Jess are going to be the team that will probably get along more than Benoit and Zadlan here.
They would absolutely have to be, especially since Benoit and Zadlan absolutely hate each other here. They've been in a feud all over back in Season 3, but Kincaid and Jess haven't really hated each other here, really just kind of a newfound friendship maybe here.
Of course, friendship will go out the window, of course, Maz, come Sunday night when it's one for all in that Elimination Chamber, the Vile Chamber, of course. And, well, you have to say, well, look at this, Ben Ward and Zadlan working as a team. Who thought they would have seen that, Maz?
Yeah, I think maybe Luke Benward just wanted to get out of the ring, so he could tag Zadlan in there, but Zadlan obliged and got in there, but he's being taken to school right now by Kincaid, really working over the head and neck area.
Of course, the classic battles that we've seen from Zadlan and Kincaid over the last few weeks, of course. Zadlan, we thought Kincaid was going to win the title here last week, of course, with that big, when he caught Zadlan coming in, with the big code breaker, but of course Zadlan kicked out and managed to get the reversal there, and all of a sudden, Raw is going to continue though, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back with the conclusion of our main event. Marky?
Yeah, well guys, we got ourselves ECW Championship will be on the line this Wednesday, of course. The Turncoat Bulldog versus SBL. Who is going to be the champion going into the draft?
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, it is ECW's first ever special. It is In Your House 2 points. Join us for the ECW extravaganza. It comes your way same time on Wednesday night. And of course, all titles from ECW will be on the line.
2 points.
Oh, look at that lovely by Benoit. We come back just in the nick of time.
This could be it already.
Kick at it too. And Zadlan looking very pleased with Benoit on his head. But of course, Benoit has done most of this match during the commercial break. And, well, dominating Adrian Kincaid in there.
I think if you were the champion, your opponent's in there exerting all their energy and maybe possibly getting injured.
Yeah, that is true. Of course, we don't want any injuries. Look, Zadlan missing duck in the... shot by Kincaid, who's rightly getting out of there now. And here comes Jess Jarrett back in. But Jess Jarrett just seen Zadlan, and you've seen there's just the fear in his eyes. But now, nice reversal here. He's really got to try and do something to get Zadlan off his feet. And really, you don't want to anger the big man. Jarrett sending Kincaid in. Zadlan with the big back elbow. Zadlan sent for the right.
Off the ropes.
Yeah, big back elbow. Maz, you've got to see here, between this matchup, these four men, of course, if you had, just 1 second, is anyone, even Jess Jarrett can do a Russian leg sweep, if you had, of course, Rob Dundee and, of course, Ryan Fox into the match, what a six-man that's going to be.
It's going to be off the chain, and I can't wait to see what they do in Elimination Chamber when all the rules are pretty much out the window, and the Unforgivable Steel is use, and it's going to be a great match.
Look at Jess Jarrett. I don't know what he was thinking there. Maybe he was thinking going to the top rope, but then realized maybe better of it here. Look out.
Yeah, but...
Atomic drop right across the tailbone. Jarrett and Kincaid in control of our World Heavyweight Champion here. And if this happens Sunday night, we could be seeing a new World Heavyweight Champion. And of course, Zadlan, who has held the title since WrestleMania 3, of course. And now... Look at this, Jess Jarrett and Kincaid in complete control. He has double team coming up here.
Oh,
and well executed there, Marky.
Yeah, very well executed. I don't know if we're going to be seeing any of those moves by Benward and Zadlan, but the big code breaker, and this could be it.
Yeah, the code breaker. Is that enough to put away Zadlan? Yes, it is.
Yes.
My goodness, Adrian Kincaid has pinned our World Heavyweight Champion just 6 nights. From the chamber, Maz, that is huge.
Can Kate do that at the pay-per-view at Elimination Chamber and walk out as your World Heavyweight Champion?
It can happen, ladies and gentlemen. The marker has been set for Sunday night. Jess Jarrett and Adrian Kincaid win your main event here tonight on Raw. What is going to happen in the chamber? It will happen in 6 nights. Whoa, what a night, ladies and gentlemen. Marky Marks has always said goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fam.
Thanks for your company. See you back to the fans.
Click that like button and we'll see you next time, fans.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks very much for being a part of NSW Raw. If you've watched us on the network, please like, share, leave a comment. We'll get back to you as much as we can. But for Dave Easton and everyone here, thanks for watching Raw. We'll see you for ECW 2 Points.